everyone, good day all. Welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we'll start the basics of the db2 on mainframe. In this slide we'll discuss the basics of the db2. First one is the data is the collection of information that carries the business value. Next one is the database is a repository that holds use volume. Repository means a place or a container in which data is stored for the large quantity. Next one is the database management system. It's manages the creation, organization and modification of database, and also it manages the access control. In this slide we'll understand what is the evolution, how db2 comes in this picture. First one is the file is the sequential database. So there were some issues in file, like file has no random access, data security access, data management access. After file, we'll get a vxam dataset. Vxam is the virtual storage access method. It's overcome some file issue, like it supports random access and improves security. But vxam has still some integrity and management issue. After that, db2 comes in this picture. So db2 is the relational database. db2 has the lots of feature, and db2 overcome all the issue which occurred in file and vxam. So db2 has a data integrity, high availability, data security. It has a zero downtime. In this slide we'll discuss what is the db2. So db2 is the relational database. It's a IBM second database product, and db2 introduced in 1983. If we talk about the availability of db2, so it will available in two flavors. First one is the db2 for GOS, and next one is the db2 for LUW. If we talk about the market value, so db2 is used or working in the banking sector, Indian Airlines, top retailer, global health and insurance and all. In next slide we'll discuss db2 for GOS. So first version was introduced on 7 June 1983. We already know db2 is the second IBM database product, and IMS is the first IBM database product. It's a very old product. The latest version of db2 is the version 13. So if we talk about db2, it's a software which manages the data storage and retrieve method. db2 is the faster way of accessing data. When we log into a mainframe like a TSO environment, so there are different environment. db2 is not a single system. It has separated by the subsystem. Subsystem means it's a every environment we have a separate installation or LPAR. LPAR, that means a logical partition. Each installation is identified as a subsystem. And subsystem is, recalled as the SSID, and it has the 4 character. Now we'll understand db2 structure. So db2 is divided into two parts. For first one is the data structure, and second was the system structure. So in this session we'll discuss the data structure. In data structure we have a storage group, database, table space, table, index, view, alias, synonyms, schema and all. Next one is the system structure. So in system structure we have db2 catalog, db2 directory, bootstrap dataset, active log, archive log, buffer pool, resource limit, work file, database and all. So first we understand data structure. In data structure we have a storage group. So a storage group means it's a defined area on a disk used for a stored table and index. Next one is the database. So here database is the relational database, we already know. In database we have a table space. So table space, that means all table within the db2 are stored in the table space. A table space is a storage structure that consists of vxam dataset. There are different types of storage space, different types of table space, like a partition by growth, partition by range, segmented table space. In table space we have a table. Table, that means, is a one of the most basic structure within a db2. It's store the data. In table we have index, column, view, alias and synonym. If we talk about the index, so index is just like index for a book. DB2 index are used to quickly locate the information without having to read all the content and all. And index is stored in its own index space. So next one is the view. So view is also an alternative way of representing data that exists in one or more table. Next one is the alias. Alias is the statement specify one or more table additional name for the primary entry point and can also specify name of alternate entry point. And the next DB2 has a second part. Second part is the system structure. So we'll discuss system structure in upcoming session. Thank you all. If you want a more video, please like, share and subscribe. Subscribe and thank you all.